In this video, I'm going to show you how to add an announcement to your Google Classroom. There are a lot of different reasons why you could use the announcement in Google Classroom. One might be that you just simply want the students to go to a certain Newsela article and you have a link there. You just want them to come in the classroom for language arts and sit down and begin reading it, and then a whole class discussion might ensue after, or a small group discussion. You may have the students write in a journal or on a Google Doc and share it with you later. So right here after you hover over the plus sign, you have your four options. The first one is create an announcement. So we'll click on that. And then I'll put in the directions where it says share with your class what I want the students to do once they get to the link that I'm actually going to be adding. So I have my directions that I want the students to do. Now I'm going to create a topic. I'm going to call this science. That way, when I get quite a few announcements or posts or assignments, the students can filter anything that's language arts or anything that's math, and it'll make it easier for them to muddle through the posts that start building up. What I do when I want to find a website or link is I go to Google and I just type in, for this example, precipitation activities for kids. And I came up with this neat little science experiment. So before we do the experiment, I'm going to copy this link. I'm going to actually have them read the assignment and talk about some of the things, some of their predictions. I kind of go through that modeling of you know, what a scientist does before they actually embark upon an experiment. So you click the link icon. That looks like a little chain link. And then you're going to go Control V to paste it in there, or right click and paste. And then don't forget to click Add Link. And now my link is here. Again, you can make this available for all students. I have no students in this class. Or you can only make it available for certain students. So I'm going to go ahead. Again, you can schedule this or save it as a draft and come back to it. I just want to post it right now. Now I want to point out right here where it says add class comment. Right now my preferences are set up so that only the teacher can comment. But when you go into students, and it's not going to show up right now because right now I have no students in here, but there is going to appear a navigation bar where you can actually allow the students to post. And this is what we call blogging. And this is another form of writing. It's highly engaging. The kids do it on their phones and in the different applications they use. So it's super engaging and motivating for the kids. And before you do that, you may want to go over some norms, some rules, maybe some sentence frames of what should be used, and then the kids can comment here, and you can set up maybe a rule that you respond with your comment, and then you read others and you respond to one other comment. For more information on how to do this, I can come model this, or you can just email me at rmacdonald@ewcsd.org, or you can call me at extension 5924. But this is one way of adding an announcement, and there are a bunch of different ways that you can discuss or share out once students review the material that you share. I hope this helps, and more to come.